El cambio means change in Spanish. So it's a Spanish word meaning change. We want to make a change for children. So we do this through football, elite football, the best education when it comes to football they can get in Central Africa. Then we give them a really good education on private school. Later on, we're gonna build our own school. And then we have this character program. So we are working in three areas: football, education, and character. And character is maybe the most important one, because at El Cambio we want to make this change, not just for our children here, but for children outside. But we can only do that if these children are having good moral principles, having values, knowing that they are normal role models, because for them to have El Cambio on their chest, it comes with responsibility. Everybody in Uganda wants to join. We only take in the very best players from Uganda and in a few years from whole Central Africa. So it's very hard to get in. We only bring in 8 a year for a full scholarship. 8 years full scholarship, everything is paid for. So El Cambio wants to grow these children to become good characters. So next to football and education, we have a lot of sessions. I also think that not just sessions and theory about how to be a good man or a girl or whatever. It's very important that all the staff, we have the right environment around them, that it is safe. We are so much into this that the children, they feel safe. So El Cambio is a safe place to be as a child. It is also a demanding place, because having such a potential, being so good, comes with responsibility. They need to help other children. So El Cambio is change. We want to make a change, not just for our children, but for Uganda and whole, for children, for coaches, for the federation. We are here for Uganda. El Cambio Academy has huge visions and ambitions, but at the same time, we try to stay humble, respectful towards everyone. So let's see if we can make it. What I'm going to tell you now, it can only happen if all of us, we're supporting each other. FUFA, all the coaches, El Cambio, children, parents, everyone needs to support the idea of youth football. Now, what we would like is to build up a girls program. In 2 or 3 years, we should have girls coming in as well. In 5 years, we should have 70 children of the best in whole Central Africa. Now, in some more years to come, these children will be spread out to Europe and America. Now, another thing is we want to build our own complex, El Cambio complex. So we want to have our own school with a curriculum from America, so they're ready to go abroad. We want to have 7 football pitches in different sizes. We want to have a dormitory where they sleep, a kitchen, everything combined, a big complex where the El Cambio family is, so that whenever people are coming in, this is elite program. So my name is Thomas Thor. I'm from Denmark, 37 years old. And I've been working in football, I would say almost all my life, in different ways. And like 8 years ago, I think I was a part of FC Nordsjælland, one of the biggest clubs in Denmark that are known for talent development. I worked there with under 17 and under 15 squads. So I started in an early age. I got connected to a lot of influential people in Denmark, and I have a passion for football. I played myself when I was young. I came to this club, FC Nordsjælland in Denmark. I improved and as a professional coach there, and but I wanted more. I wanted more. It was not enough for me to be in Denmark to help some children there. Most children in Denmark, they have a good life. I wanted to give back and help more children who are more in need. So I remembered back. And when I was 20, I went to West Africa, and I went there to coach children. And I really liked the passion. I liked the culture here. I liked the people here in Uganda, here in Africa. So I felt like when I stopped at Nordsjælland, I wanted to try something else. I then came on a contract at Right to Dream. Right to Dream is one of the best academies in the world, located in Ghana. So actually here in Africa, you have one of the best academies in the world. Not that many people know about it. I came there and I was there for 8 months, and I worked hard as an under 15 coach there. I got to know how they have built it all up. And then I told myself, I want to create my own academy with my values, with what I believe in, my philosophy. And then I looked around and I wanted to find the right place for my academy where I have my lifetime project. Because this is not just for a short time, this is for the rest of my life. And even maybe for my children to grow up in it. So suddenly, a coincidence, I came up to Uganda because of a common friend. He recommended to come here. And here you haven't developed the football for real. So you have a lot of potential, because I've seen those children around the country. You have some very talented boys, even more talented than in Denmark, where I'm from. But we need to nurture it. We need to bring the environment so that they can grow. I came here 3 years ago and I started up an academy together with another one. After 1.5 year, we had to split up. That was a Ugandan guy. We had to split up, and then now El Cambio is now alive again, and we have existed as we are now for 1 year. So for a coincidence, I would say I ended up here, but most importantly, it is because I want to help children. So first of all, I couldn't do this without great staff, support from Uganda, support from Denmark. Yes, I am the founder, I'm the director, but I needed a lot of help. So coming to Uganda, I needed to find out the culture. I needed to find the right staff members. I found perfect staff members that shares the value and perspective and passion for leading young children. This is the only thing I'm looking at. Maybe they're not the best coaches right now when I found them. That doesn't matter. So that is also my approach to the whole of Uganda, that this is so much about leadership. How to carry yourself, how to be a role model, how to inspire children. I found those staff members around me now at El Cambio, and they have helped me finding out where can we play from, what about school, and how can we scout, how can we find players. And of course, we shared my knowledge from Denmark, from Europe. At El Cambio, we have scouts. So we have two or three of them that are traveling around Uganda right now. Later on, we will put up scouts in different countries. Right now, we are going to look for tips, technique, intelligence, personality, and speed. So we are looking for those four elements in a player. When we go to a school tournament, whatever kind of tournament here, we are looking for those qualities. If we find that in one child, it's really rare that someone has all those, because one thing is technique. Can you actually move the ball while moving your body? Intelligence, do you know when to pass, when to dribble? Do you get the game understanding? Personality, that's when we talk about character. Do we see a child who is willing to take the responsibility on the pitch? And then in the end, speed. Are you able to run fast, straight, but also sideways? All these components together makes a great player in the future. So we are looking for creative players, talented players who are really good at moving the ball, technical players, entertaining players. That is what we want to do here. We want Ugandan Cranes in the future to be entertaining and winning at the same time. So everyone here on the TV or in Mandela Stadium, they will be very proud. They will be proud of the Cranes. That is our ambition. And the only way we can do that is having entertaining players, skillful players who can make something happen that we didn't expect. So what we do here is always we set up this as scouting. We look for creative players. Secondly, we have an environment where we nurture these things. So all our exercises, they are built around this being creative. So that is very important to us. And then we also need to bring in the right coach, because the right coach and the right leadership makes the children try and try and try. But if you have someone, you have brought in technical players, but you have a coach that are screaming at them, they will never do it. Important thing for me is the character. So the first thing that a child comes, when a child comes to our academy, he will experience that the Basungus, we, the Ugandan, all the staff are looking respectfully at them. So yes, we are not equal in the way of responsibility, but we see each other as equal human beings. So whenever someone is 8 years old and he's coming, I will listen to him. I will respect his decision. I will make him feel loved. We are giving a lot of hugs. We tell them that we love them because we really do care for these children. So the first thing is for a child when he comes to El Cambio that he feels like, wow, this is another family. I remember my family back home, but this is a really nice family for me. We talked about character, but education is just as important as football, because the thing is about football, it's very difficult to become a pro. We know how it is here in Uganda. It's very different. So we need them to really work hard in school. When we send them to school, we make sure we have private sessions. We bring in American teachers to educate them even better. We are waiting to build our own school, but in the meantime, we are pushing them a lot. So if they don't perform well, if they don't try their best, of course they cannot play. So they know education is maybe even more important for them in their life than football. But of course, football is their passion. So the children are very humble, more than enough, because they feel like shy. Most children, when they come, they feel shy. They are not supposed to really talk to adults. They feel like they have nothing to say, that adults, the staff members, coaches are not really interested in them. But we are. We are so interested in them. So the biggest challenge would be for them to grow, being proud of themselves, have self-esteem and self-worth, feeling that they are good enough as they are. I think that is the biggest challenge. Most children, when they come, they feel like they're just small children. But no, small children can have a big voice. But the coach is the right character. When I say the right character, it is for him to be able to respect children, to treat them well, with respect, but also to push them in all areas. These children, they should feel love, but at the same time, that a lot of pressure is coming. Because without pressure, they will just relax. No one of these ones. They have such a big potential. If they start relax, they will vanish. So we need to push them a lot. So the coach for El Cambio, he needs to be someone who is loving, demanding, and also have a lot of knowledge in terms of football. These children you see in the background here, they are nurtured in this environment and they have 8 years free scholarship. The dream is, and it's not just a dream, it will happen, that whenever some of them are turning 15, 16 years old, they go to America for scholarships. So in America, the schools are competing against each other just like here in Africa. In Denmark, it's different. We have academies, we have clubs competing. But in America, they really want that school team to perform well. And at the same time, if an American school can take in one of our children, it is like a social responsibility. They help someone out. So we will, when they turn 15, 16, send some of them. The best ones, the very best ones of these ones, we will keep them until they're 18. When they're 18, they can go professional in Europe. And then we can make a transfer. That transfer, all the money that comes to El Cambio, doesn't go to my pocket as normally. No, it goes to develop even this academy. Maybe we set up another academy in Gulu, Kampala, whatever, in Mbarara, somewhere, so that we can help more children. So the whole aim here is either they go for education and football in America, or they go to play professional in Europe. And then always remember giving back. So the main thing here about El Cambio is El Cambio giving back. So whenever some of these children are going either to America for studies, or they go to Europe to play football, they'll remember where are they from. Who were the coach in the beginning? What about the school they went to when they were young, before coming here? And all their friends, parents and so on, grandparents. Come back and help your environment. Help back where they still are here. Some of them might still need some help. So let's say that we have one player who's really passionate about being a doctor. He should come back, treat children, maybe build a hospital with his resources like money, network, passion. So wherever they go, they come back and help the Ugandan society. The biggest dream for me is that one of these children go abroad, they study, they play football, whatever they do. But for me, it's not enough that one of our children ends up at Camp Nou to play for Barcelona. I will be there, of course, and I will cheer for him because I know him, it's one of my children. But it's not enough. It's enough, and my vision and El Cambio vision, where I feel proud and I might cry, is when we see this child going back to Uganda, making that change. Because he has now this status. He's in a situation, he's now a role model. But he's not only a real role model if he does something with that position in a good way to help other children. So whenever one of our children comes back to Uganda and help, that is when I know that El Cambio is working. For me as a founder and having those visions and I really want to make a change, it is that that I really come and I really want to try to help. That is my main ambition. And I want to try to help with the lead environment. But such a kind of academy that we are bringing, people don't know about it. So people from Kampala, from wherever, they don't understand what we are. So having you here to explain more, it makes people maybe to realize that this is very different. It is not just another academy competing against each other, coaches against each other. No, this is different. And we need to tell the story so that Uganda get to understand that El Cambio is very, it's a change.